The stuff you need to make a fire extinguisher is some water, 2 sheets of toilet paper, soap, tape, a toothpick, some vinegar, any type works, a bottle, and some baking soda.
All right, this is what you're gonna do. You're gonna put a hole about that big in your bottle, and then you're gonna open your bottle, get out some vinegar, pour vinegar until you have about, I don't know, an inch and a half or so, maybe even less, about that much. Well, it's too much. It's good. And then you fill it up about 3/4 the way with water. You need a little room left so that you can put your baking soda in. Then you squirt some dish soap in it. You need a pretty good bit. It's to break down the toilet paper so that the baking soda will drop in. And then you take toilet paper, get some baking soda, you'll need about that much, maybe a little more. About that much. Spread it around so you don't have a big clump. And then roll it up halfway. And then roll it up the rest of the way. And then bring it up together to where you've got like a U, I guess. And then twist the top. And put the twist through the hole in the bottle. Thread it up through the top. This can be kind of hard sometimes. Need about that much so it doesn't fall out. And then tip it, let out all the excess baking soda that's gonna fall out. And then here's the hardest part. You gotta get the little bag of baking soda into the top of the bottle without completely dropping it in. So be careful not to let it slip out of the top of the bottle. Just kinda gotta work this in here. It's probably the hardest part. And don't push it in with too much force because it'll break and then the vinegar and baking soda will react and it'll spray everywhere. And then if you're doing it inside, you'll get it all over the walls and then have to clean it off and then have to pay for the paint like I did. Okay, almost got it here. Sorry, this is taking a little while. Alright, just about got it. Alright, screw on your cap and maybe a little bit of the bag can touch the water, but you don't want much to touch. And it is done. But you need to take your toothpick, put it on the side, and tape it on. Because if you're not going to use this right now, if you actually need to put out a fire, you're going to need to have that to activate it. So let's go show you how to use it. In other videos I've seen, when people do this, they just push this through with their fingers. I don't think that works. I use a toothpick to ram it through. Make sure it's not jammed or anything. Push it all the way through when you're going to use it. And let's show you how it works. Shake it up a little bit. And it just sprays out really well.